my friend Mark, Barking Badger. Woof woof. He's into the quadcopters and he wants a gimbal. Well, I had this gimbal and it worked for a little bit, and then something went wrong with it, and the board, this board here, it's blown. I'm not sure why, not sure what's wrong with it. So I went on the internet, I bought a replacement board, brand new board. So I'm hoping it's going to be a simple matter just swapping this over. So it's the same board as you can see. So what I'm going to do, simply undo these four screws. So I'm going to unplug and plug in as I go, so therefore I'm not going to get mixed up. So that one there can come out, and that one can go to there. That one there can come out, and that one can go to there. Now, I'm hoping that the board, the gyros on that little board there, are okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to plug that out, unplug that, put that over there, take that one from there, and plug it. There we are. So that's it. Should work now. It should work. We'll give it a quick test. The moment of truth fast approaches. One word of caution, Mark, that before you start the gimbal up, you must install your GoPro because it needs a weight, a load on the gimbal for it to work. And if you haven't got the GoPro on, it does all sorts of weird things. So just a word of caution, there you are. All I need to do now is apply power and see what happens. Yeah, there we go. Look, it's working. Yeah, brilliant. You see that, Mark? It's working a treat, a dream. You've got a little light on up here. Couple of little LEDs. Now these pins here, the left pin, the top left pin, there's three pins in a, well, six pins altogether, three in each line. The top right hand pin, that's that one there, goes to your F1 controller on your NASA flight control unit. And that will make the camera pitch up and down, tilt up and down. Now if you find that when you mount it on, it's at that funny angle like that all the time, you've got to connect this right hand one to the F2 connector on the NASA controller, and then that allows you to incrementally adjust and set the actual this axis. So I don't know what axis that is, Z axis or whatever, but anyway, it's working. Look, there you go, Mark. Just got to put the rubber grommets on. You'll have to get your own GoPro strap, because this is mine and I've only got one. So there's your gimbal, Mark. I've mounted the rubber grommets, which are for isolation damping. There, all you've got to do is just, they're a bit fiddly, but you've got to squeeze them up and get them through there like that, all four of them. And then what I'd also do, just for security, I would put a little cable tie through. Make sure that you don't squeeze it down. Just a little cable tie through, because if the grommets do pop out, then of course there's the potential for the whole unit and GoPro to tumble like a bomb. So just put a couple of little small cable ties through a couple of these, just to hold it there, just in case these grommets come loose. I'll let you fit that onto there, because you might want to work out how you're going to locate that on your 550. So I'll box it all up and I'll send it out to you tomorrow. And I hope this has been of interest and use to someone else as well, who's thinking it's got a gimbal. This is the cheap Chinese brushless gimbal available on eBay. And that's the name of the board. Gimbal controller GLB V3.1 two axis, and very, very simple to replace. I'll put that in there for you as well. You don't need that's the spare one.